Assalamu alaikum guys, it is Mohammed Saheb from MS Lectures. Today I will be demonstrating you about how the abnormal tissue growth occurs. We all know that cardiovascular diseases are very common in causing the deaths, but 20% of the deaths are caused by the abnormal tissue growths, which includes the lung cancer, rectal cancer, breast cancer and prostate cancer. Actually, this abnormal tissue growth is referred as the tumor atavism. Tumor atavism is actually the pathogenic growth of the tissue. And if you see the qualitative and quantitative features, we have divided these tumors into two types. First of all, it is the benign, and second is the malignant tumor. Benign tumor, it is the localized tumor. It do not metastasize. But if you talk about the malignant tumor, it actually metastasize and spread. There are several growth points from where the original tumor, it is spread to the other parts of the body. So that is all about benign and malignant tumor. Now we will talk about that, how malignant tumor and from where the malignant tumor arises. We have the carcinoma, which arises from the epithelium. And we all know that the epithelium is the major constituent of the skin. Then we have the adenocarcinomas, which arise from the glandular epithelium. And then we have the sarcomas, which arise from the mesenchymal epithelium. Now, we'll be talking about the different types of carcinogens. We have actually three types of carcinogens: chemical, physical, and biological. First of all, talking about the chemical carcinogens, chemical carcinogens arise from the different coal compounds burning and also from the tobacco burning. And these actually cause the lung cancer in our body. Now, talking about the types of chemical compounds, we have the two types. First of all, organic and then inorganic. If we talk about organic, we have the polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons, heterocyclic aromatic hydrocarbons, we have nitrosomals, we have amylose compounds, we have epioxides, and we have plastics in it. Now, I will be talking about the inorganic chemical compounds. Inorganic chemical compounds are characterized into exogenous compounds and the endogenous compounds. So exogenous compounds consist of the different elements, like we have cobalt, we have arsenic, and these compounds are referred as the exogenous compound. And talking about the endogenous compounds actually are formed when there is physical and chemical modifications of the byproducts of our normal metabolism, like bile salt, tryptophan. When they undergo physical and chemical transformation in the cell, so endogenous chemical compounds are formed and they have toxic effects in the body. Now, we are talking about that how the any carcinogen causes the carcinogenicity in our body and what is that process. First of all, the carcinogen is in its inactive form. Now, I will be talking about that what is the process of carcinogenicity in our body. And how carcinogen affects our body. Actually, the carcinogen is, first of all, in its inactive form, and it is known as the procarcinogen, and then it is converted into the final oncogene. And how this process occurs? First of all, initiation and then promotion. In the process of the initiation, that particular carcinogen actually attacks on the cell DNA, which control all the activities of the body. So it alters and cause the alteration in the genome of the cell and reduce the tumors in that particular cell. So in this way, the initiation process continues to follow. Now, furthermore, I would like to talk about that how this initiation process proceeds. We have two types, genomic and epigenomic. In the genomic, only point mutation of the cell occurs. And if we talk about the epigenomic, in this what happens that proto-oncogenes are converted into the final oncogenes. And after this conversion into the final oncogene, it is referred as the latent tumor. In this stage, it is not referred to as the tumor that has the full tumor phenotype, but it has the characteristics, that is why it is referred to as the latent tumor cell. So that is all about the process that how carcinogen, any type of carcinogen affects on our body. Now I would like to talk about the physical carcinogen. The physical carcinogen is actually any type of carcinogen that is that's coming from the environment. Like we have ultraviolet radiations and we have X-ray radiations. So the people which are working in this type of environment are likely to be caused and affected by these physical carcinogens. And in this and how physical carcinogen affects our body? The same process, initiation and progression. The physical carcinogen will affect the DNA and it will cause the alteration in our cell genome and then the process of promotion occurs. In the promotion, what will happen that first of all oncogene expression will be carried out. Now I will be talking about the biological carcinogens. Biological carcinogens are referred commonly and specifically as the oncogenes. And we have a few examples, like we have Epstein-Barr virus, which actually causes nasopharyngeal carcinoma and Burkitt's lymphoma. And then we have the T lymphocyte. Now I will be talking about the biological carcinogens. Biological carcinogens are specifically referred to as the oncogenes. And we have a few examples of this biological carcinogens. First of all, we have the Barr-Epstein virus, which causes the nasopharyngeal carcinoma disease and the Burkitt's lymphoma. Then we have the herpes simplex, which actually attacks the cervical area. And then we have the hepatitis B, and then we have the T lymphocyte carcinogen, which actually affects the T lymphocytes of our body and affects our immunity. So we have two types of the biological carcinogens. One is the DNA containing viruses and other is the RNA containing viruses. If we talk about the DNA containing viruses, what happens that the carcinogen affects the cell genome and causes the tumor transformation in the cell. It may also act as a promoter as well, and it includes the adenoviruses, parvoviruses and herpes viruses, which actually cause the Burkitt's lymphoma disease and also hepatitis B as well. Now I will be talking about the RNA containing viruses. RNA containing viruses actually cause the carcinogenicity in our body when RNA is inserted into the cell genome. But if we talk about the RNA containing viruses, first of all, that RNA strand is converted into the DNA, and that DNA is actually inserted into the cell genome easily and cause the tumor transformation in the cell, and then a new a typical new plasmid is formed, and in this way tumor transformation process continues to form. This is all about the disorders of the tissue growth.